Hi, my name is Moira MacDonald, and I'm so excited that you're joining me today to learn how to make a dragon shadow puppet and a shadow puppet theater that you can perform the dragon in. So this dragon shadow puppet was inspired by my shadow puppetry performance called The Story of Minka and Misho, which is about a dragon that steals all the colors from the world, and a brother and sister have to go rescue the colors and bring them back. So in order to make your dragon shadow puppet and shadow puppet theater, you will need a pair of scissors, some tape, some straws, they can be plastic or paper, a pencil, a thumbtack, a brass brad, and a manila folder. When we're all finished, you'll have a dragon shadow puppet, which will be performed behind a screen, and here is your theater with a screen. So if you'd like, we've provided for you a template for the shadow puppet stage. This is from an antique French puppet theater. And this is a template for the dragon. Of course, you can draw your own dragon if you'd like, and you can use a blank piece of paper and decorate your own puppet theater. But for today, we're gonna use the templates. So let's get started. First, we're going to make the shadow puppet theater. This functions as a frame and a screen for where you will perform your shadow puppet. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna start by cutting out a rectangle from the manila folder. So you're gonna draw a rectangle about an inch or an inch and a half inside the edge of the manila folder, like this. Just gonna come around here, like so, and like that. So now you're gonna take your thumbtack and you're gonna scratch a little hole in the envelope so that you can get the scissors started. Okay, like that. Next, you're gonna take your scissors and start cutting. And you're gonna cut the whole rectangle out. It's totally okay if it's not perfect. It's better if it's not perfect because then you know it's handmade. So what you should have now is this window in your manila folder, and then this rectangle. And you're gonna save this for later because this is what you're gonna make your dragon out of. Now we're gonna make the theater stand up. First, you're gonna picture a line about 3 inches away from the crease in the folder. This is the crease. You're gonna make another crease about here, okay? And you just fold it and then make a nice crease. Next, you're going to cut out another rectangle. So now you have these two slats. They are going to be what holds your theater upright. So first we need to stand your theater up, make sure if it's a little floppy, just make sure all the creases are really good. Next, we're going to tape the slats in place with your masking tape. So here's your freestanding shadow puppet theater. And here's the back. If you need to make the slats go higher or lower to make it stand better, you can just move the tape up or down. The final step in making your shadow puppet theater is you're going to take your PDF, or you're going to take a blank piece of paper and decorate it yourself, and glue or tape this piece of paper to the front of your puppet theater frame. So now, if you're taping and you don't want the tape to show, you can make a little bubble with your tape, like so, and put it just behind one of the corners, and then you're gonna do that 3 more times. Okay. There's There's the last one. Kind of press those down. So now we have your completed shadow puppet theater. Now this image that we've provided is of an antique French toy theater in which puppet performances were traditionally held. But you can use a blank piece of paper and draw your own. You can use paint, markers, glitter, glue, all kinds of stickers. Use your favorite colors. You can draw the audience, your friends, your family, your cat, or whatever you want. So now we're gonna make a dragon shadow puppet. So here is an example of a dragon shadow puppet. You can see it has a wing that can move, its body, and these straws are what are called control rods. That's how you move the shadow puppet. So you can take the template you downloaded and print it out, or you can take a blank piece of paper and draw your own dragon. Make sure if you're drawing your own dragon that you draw the wings separate from the dragon's body. Once you've drawn or printed your dragon shadow puppet, you're going to cut a circle around, a loose circle around the outside of the drawing. So, just like this, all the way around. Like this. Do you remember the rectangle we saved for later? We're gonna use it now. So you're going to take the drawing or the printout that you've cut out and tape it to the manila folder. Just a few pieces of tape to hold it in place. And now we're going to cut out the dragon's body and his wing. So sometimes I go around and I get the general shape, and then I come back in and do the details. So now you're getting to the point where you're going to separate. You've separated the dragon from the paper that was taped to the manila folder. So now you just want to hold it tightly while you're doing the final details. See, I still have the manila folder on the back. You could also put a little piece of tape to hold it together. So now we're going to finish the little details. If you used a little piece of tape to hold it together, you can take that off now. It's masking tape, nothing will rip. And there you go. You have your dragon body all cut out. Now we need to do the wing. Again, I'm just gonna go loosely around and then get the details at the end. And now you have your completed wing. Now, if you'd like to, you can decorate your dragon shadow puppet however you want. But remember, when you're performing a shadow puppet, you don't actually see the front of the puppet. You only see its shadow. But remember also that whatever makes you happy is the most important thing. So if you want to decorate it right now, go ahead. Now, we're going to make the joint so the wing can flap. This is actually one of the trickiest and more finicky parts of this process. You need your thumbtack, and you will need your brass brad. You're going to lay the wing over the dragon's body like this, just so that it's upright. And then you're going to take your thumbtack and you're going to scratch a little line through both layers of the manila folder. It's a little tricky. And you can make sure that you've made it all the way through by just poking the thumbtack through both layers, like that. So next, you're going to take your brass brad and you're going to push it through both holes, like this. See? And then you're going to fold open the brass brad, the two little pieces, like this. And now you have a moving wing. So next, you're going to attach your straws. Remember the straws? These are how you're going to move your shadow puppet without people seeing your hands. These are called control rods. First, we have to make the attachment points on the straws. You'll take your scissors and one of your straws, and you're going to cut right into the end. So once you've cut into the end of your straw, you can fold open the two pieces, like this. And that gives you a point where you can attach to the back of the dragon, to his wing. One goes to his wing, one goes to his body. And this is how you'll move. You'll use a little bit of tape to hold it in place. You can cut off the extra tape from the edge, or you can fold it over if you didn't decorate the front. So now you have the straw attached to the dragon's wing, and now he can fly. So next up, you're going to attach your other straw to the dragon's body in the exact same way. So now you have both of your straws or control rods attached to your dragon. Okay, so now is the fun part. We get to turn off the lights, grab your flashlight or your phone, and light the screen from behind while your dragon flies around. Now it's kind of interesting. You can see the rods, but that's okay. It's still better than seeing your hands. So another thing to know about the shadow puppet is if you hold it close to the screen, he's smaller. But if you hold it closer to the light, he gets big. There's more than one way to make a shadow puppet theater. You can also make a very large theater by holding up a sheet or getting some friends to hold up a sheet for you and holding a flashlight behind it and making the puppets much bigger. Or you can even make them with your hands. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you had fun, and I hope you have fun with your shadow puppet and your shadow puppet theater. I hope you've enjoyed this chapter of the Getty's fantastic journeys, myth, magic, and mysterious monsters. At the Getty website, you can also find links to two other stories with accompanying workshops. Look out for the wonderful Michael Katz telling an Eastern European tale, and the amazing Baba the Storyteller sharing a delightful yarn from Africa.